the question is, can we trust his words? Watch this video. Let us know if you think we can trust his words. These are very, very strong words right here. Let us know. Can we, I ask again, can we trust his words? Thank you. Watch, share, and like. God bless you all.
Many high-profile cases will definitely come to you, and they may likely come in company of some juicy, irresistible temptations, especially when they involve mouth-watering financial and business transactions. I'm making it clear to you now that you must flee from such disguised danger. Your reputation and integrity matter much, and it counts enormously in your rise to honor and fame in life. Let me point out unambiguously that in life, gifts and wealth that are not worked for, which are by extension undeserving, are always wrapped in calamity and destruction. Flee from them and keep your heads high above the murky waters of corruption and favoritism, so that you can be conveniently counted among the very best in the Nigerian judiciary. You must, against all odds, conduct your affairs within the ambit of the law and the oath that you has just been administered on you. If you were hitherto 50% under public scrutiny, I can then confidently tell you now that it has automatically risen to 100% by virtue of this appointment. This tempo of public assessment of your conduct and disposition will now assume astronomical proportion. You must equally redouble your effort and dialogue properly with your conscience in order not to fall out of the grace of Almighty God and the Nigerian people. It absolutely takes nothing to join the crowd, but it takes quite a lot to stand alone with good conscience. Several novel business and industrial disputes are occurring in the country virtually on a daily basis that have now inevitably made litigations to go on a steady rise. No court in the land is spared of this. We are constantly on our toes, and the dockets are ever rising in response to the challenges of the time. This underscores the fact that Nigeria ranks among the most litigious countries in the whole world. The onus is on your lordships to fasten your belt and roll up your sleeves to face the challenges head on. You must redouble your pace to catch up with the expectations of the litigants. As judicial officers, you have a defined mandate on half that you must discharge with unveiled honesty and sincerity. You must give good account of yourselves to justify your appointment. However, if you decide to do the contrary, of course, the sledgehammer will, without hesitation, descend heavily on you. No judicial officer at any level of our courts will be allowed to drag the reputation of the Nigerian judiciary into the mud. We can't come this far to fail. Take heed of this admonition by working rightly towards occupying an enviable space in the annals of the Nigerian judiciary.